Thanks for volunteering with the great 2024 Huron River Mussel Hunt with the Huron River Watershed Council. This video will get you oriented to the project and what to expect as a volunteer. HRWC and the City of Ypsilanti are working together to remove Peninsular Paper Dam. The dam removal will return the river to a free-flowing system and will improve the Huron River's water quality and wildlife habitat. However, there are a lot of steps needed to remove a dam safely, and one of these steps is to survey the river for freshwater native mussels. When a dam is removed, the sediment that has been trapped behind the dam will be released and potentially blanket the downstream river bottom. While most animals can move away, like fish, mussels are often buried, so the sediments will harm or kill them. Similarly, when the upstream impoundment is drained, many creatures, including mussels, are left stranded in the old lake bottom. Dam removals are carefully planned to prevent too much disturbance and mortality. However, some amount of mussel death is still expected after a dam removal. This summer, HRWC wants to understand what species of mussels we have around the dam area. In particular, there are known federally endangered species in the Huron River, the snuffbox and rayed bean, and these may be near the dam. We also expect to find a state-listed species, the wavy rayed lamp mussel. An easy solution to saving the mussels is to move them to another part of the river before the dam is removed. The mussel relocation part of this project is planned for 2025. Here are the top 7 important things to know as you volunteer to help with HRWC's mussel survey. First of all, mussel surveys can only be done when the river is running low and clear. Rainy weather on the day of or days before an outing may result in us having to cancel that outing. HRWC will email and text any cancellations by the evening before the outing. Because your volunteer session could be canceled due to weather, we encourage you to sign up for several different days. Also, if you need to cancel your participation, please let us know as soon as possible so we can find someone to take your volunteer slot. Throughout the weeks of our survey, we'll be moving to different sections of the Huron River and Ypsilanti for our mussel sampling. Pay attention to the emails and texts we send you to find out where to park on that particular day. You're going to get wet. Expect to be fully submerged in the river. Come dressed in swimwear or a wetsuit and water shoes or old sneakers. You will not be allowed to participate if you have bare feet, as there could be broken glass or sharp rocks in the river. If you have your own mask and snorkel, we encourage you to bring it. Otherwise, HRWC will provide one. You should also bring drinking water, a snack or lunch, a towel, and sunscreen. HRWC will run a weighted rope across the river, called a transect line. A line leader will direct each volunteer to their own 5-meter section of this rope and then start a timer. For 10 minutes, you will search the bottom of the river for mussels, searching methodically across your 5-meter section. You will look a 1/2 meter upstream from the transect line and a 1/2 meter downstream from the transect line. You can visualize a 1/2 meter distance as about the length of your arm. To find the mussels, you'll move large rocks out of the way and dig into the sediment 6 inches with a trowel. In shallower water, you can use a glass bottom bucket to search. In water above your knees, you should be using a snorkel and mask and be fully immersing yourself in the water. When you find a mussel, you'll pull it out and put a heavy washer where you found it. You will then signal for an ID expert who will come to you to identify your mussel and record it on their data sheet. You'll keep looking during this time. When the expert is done, you will then put that mussel back in the same location and pick up the washer. If an ID expert is busy with another volunteer, you will put the mussel in a mesh laundry bag and go back to searching until the expert comes to help you. If you find more than one mussel in the 5-meter section you are surveying, you will have to do what is called a quantitative sample. Your line leader will place down a square made of PVC tubes in a randomly determined location near the area you had previously searched. You will search only in this square. It will set a timer for 2 minutes, and like you've already done, you search for mussels by moving all large rocks out of the way and using a trowel to dig down 6 inches into the sediment. All of the mussels you find will be put into the mesh laundry bag you're holding, and when the 2 minutes are up, the mussels will be recorded and put back into the river. The quantitative sample process is then repeated twice more in different randomly determined locations. Mussels will be mostly, but not entirely, buried in the rocks and sediment on the bottom of the river. In your search, you will look for shells poking out of the sediment. Many of them will be open just a little bit to allow them to breathe. Mussels may display a lure, which is a little flare of the interior mantle meant to attract fish. If you see anything unusual that looks like a fish or insect or colorful plant waving in the water, get a closer look at it because it might be a mussel. If you put a mussel back into the sediment the wrong way, it will likely suffocate and die because mussels can't put themselves back to their proper position. Therefore, it is very important to learn how to put mussels back into the river safely.
The easiest way to remember to put a mussel back is that the clean side goes into the sediment. Bury it about halfway down. If there is no obvious clean side, you'll have to use mussel morphology. The anterior end goes down into the sediment. To tell the difference between posterior and anterior end, remember this. The beak points or leans toward the anterior end. Also, the anterior end is the short end of the mussel. Ants are small, and so is the anterior side. In summary, put the clean end down. If you can't tell the difference, put the anterior side down. The anterior side is the small side, and also the way the beak leans.
Thank you so much for volunteering for this important, tough, yet fun job. HRWC staff and mussel experts will be on site for every outing to explain the procedure again and answer any questions. They'll see you out at the river.